I was always impressed by Black Amber's design and build quality. And the Citadel is one of my favorite bags. Longtime viewers know that I'm not a big fan of rolltop backpacks, but now Black Amber created their first rolltop backpack. Can they convince me to like rolltop backpacks? Let's find out. This is the Black Amber's WPRT Modular. WPRT is short for Waterproof Roll Top, and this bag is also available in the minimal version. Before I go into all of the details of this pre-production unit, let's do a quick roundup of all the important features of this backpack. 25 to 30 liters capacity. Instant Connect Magnetic V-Buckle. Roll Top and Top Loading. But also side access to the main compartment, laser cut and bonded YKK AquaGuard zippers with zipper garage, IPX6 rated waterproof construction, 800 Denier Micro Hex 3 layer performance textile, laser cut and bar-tacked Hyperlon to attach the modules or straps, aircraft grade aluminum hardware, suspended laptop sleeve, quick access front compartment with slots and magnetic quick release key, 3D shoulder straps, active fit back panel that is supposed to move independently to fit your specific shape and has two hidden pockets. I'm a big fan of how Black Amber designs their bags and their choices of materials. Everything feels high quality and very durable. And in that regard, just like the Citadel, the WPRT does not disappoint. Furthermore, they step it up even further by giving it an IPX6 rating and making it even more waterproof. When it comes down to the question if a bag is waterproof or even just water resistant, I always say that even if the material is waterproof, there's always a chance of water getting into the bag through seams or openings eventually. But Black Amber did a great job to prevent water getting into the bag. Obviously, if you don't close a zipper properly, water will get into the bag. But if you close all the AquaGuard zippers and park them in the zipper garage, water can't get through them into the bag. Furthermore, the amount of stitching from outside to the inside has been drastically reduced compared to other bags, which helps to keep water outside the bag. Most of the bag parts, like the zippers for instance, are laser cut and bonded. I'm not 100% sure what bonded means. Maybe it's some kind of heat welding, heat bonding or gluing. But from what I can tell, it's a very strong and durable connection. This is the modular version, so you can customize the bag to your liking with pouches, utility or compression straps to add extra compartments or carrying options on the outside of the bag. One option that I would recommend to get is a second grab handle for the side of the bag. I personally added this vertical pouch on the outside and I have the so-called DSLR pack that goes inside the main compartment and that safely stores either your camera or fragile equipment like hard drives. But overall, I would recommend to highly evaluate which of the pouches you want and you actually need, because every single pouch will add weight and will make the bag bigger. Speaking of big, I also use this bag a lot for grocery shopping and you can fit a bunch of stuff into this bag. The bag is big, but not too big to look overwhelming on my back, and the 3D shoulder straps feel very soft and comfortable on my shoulders. But while the shoulder straps are very comfortable, the very soft padded back panel surprisingly didn't feel that comfortable for my size. While I really loved the comfort of the Citadel, which has a slightly curved back of the WPRT is flat. I tried to readjust the harness multiple times, but the lower part of the back panel or the backpack always slightly poked into my lower back and felt kinda stiff. Black Amber have done such a great job with their Citadel backpack, and it's one of my favorite bags, so I can't help to compare the WPRT against the Citadel. I love the bright silver inner lining of the Citadel because you can see everything inside even when you're just slightly open the main compartment. But the WPRT is a perfect example why I'm not a big fan of top-loading roll-top backpacks. They usually are just big and deep black holes. Black Amber actually specifies their 800 denier 3-layer microhex performance textile as deep black to reduce reflectivity for a stealthy aesthetic.
In terms of looks, this is awesome, but in practice, there are some trade-offs.
First, this material makes it extremely difficult to find your items inside the main compartment. I'm sure that there is a good reason for this design, but it does make packing and unpacking unnecessarily difficult in my humble opinion. Secondly, this stealthy and non-reflective design can be dangerous for some of the bag's intended use cases. Usually, waterproof roll-top backpacks like this are perfect for cyclists or motorbike riders. But having a big black non-reflective bag on your back can reduce your visibility to other people drastically. I like to use this bag either on my bicycle or motorbike, so I added this highly reflective band and a bicycle light to one of the attachment points. Another item I added to this bag is this X-wrap protective cloth or just a sweater to the bottom of the bag, because the bottom of the bag is not padded at all, so you really need to be careful when dropping items into the bag or dropping the bag on the ground. The laptop compartment is suspended, so your expensive laptop is safe from bumping on the ground. But the compartment's wall facing to the main compartment is not padded, so take care of your laptop as well when loading hard items into the main compartment if the laptop is inside its compartment.
I need to remind you that this is a pre-production unit and some of the negative points might change, but what's my verdict so far? Unfortunately, I have to say that I'm still not a big fan of roll-top top-loading backpacks because it is hard to pack, unpack and find stuff in the deep black hole that is the main compartment. And the WPRT is a very good example of that. If this bag had the silver inner lining, then my biggest gripe would be solved, because this bag is very well made, very durable, and I would trust this bag to keep all of my items dry in a rainstorm on a motorbike where winds usually press water inside any other bag. And I really like the modular system. Yes, the bag, or rather the bag panel, wasn't as comfortable compared to the other Black Amber bags that I tested, but maybe I wasn't able to find the right setting for the harness system, or my upper body size isn't ideal for this bag, so your mileage might vary. So as you already can tell, if I had to choose between the Black Amber Citadel and the Black Amber WPRT, I would choose the Black Amber Citadel because I prefer clamshell opening backpacks. But if you also like Black Amber's design language as much as I do, and you want a durable and well-made and waterproof backpack, and you also like roll-top backpacks, then I would highly recommend to check out Black Amber's WPRT backpack. So I would like to know from you, do you like clamshell opening backpacks or do you like roll top top loading backpacks? Let me know in the comment section below. And like always, if you have any more questions, please comment below. And if you enjoyed this video, click the like button. And please feel free to subscribe to my channel and click that little bell icon so you won't miss the next videos. Thank you very much. If you're one of my Patreons, you have seen in the Patreon-only videos that I started reviewing this bag a while back. In one of my videos a while back, I explained that I don't want to do sponsorships or do ads beyond the YouTube ads. So I created this Patreon to support and grow this channel. And as a thank you, on that Patreon you can see Patreon-only videos with unboxings, previews and vlog-style videos. So don't feel obliged to support me via Patreon, but if you want to support this channel, then you can go to Patreon and as a thank you, you can see these vlog style videos. Okay, hopefully I will see you in the next video. Thank you very much.